Today we are going to be talking about doing some searching using the database ScienceDirect. So to get started, I am here on the library's homepage, library.tamucc.edu, and as you can see under our quick search bar, we have this button called Databases. And there are a couple of different aspects about our databases list. We have over 300 databases here, and so that's quite a few. But if you want to kind of narrow down, if you're looking for databases in a particular subject area, like chemistry or engineering, you can narrow down that way and just look at databases relating to those subjects. You can also, if you know what you're looking for, like right now I'm looking for ScienceDirect, I could go to the S, or I could simply start typing in ScienceDirect and then search for it. As you can see over here, we have this little Ask Us bot. So if you can't find what you're looking for, you can always chat with us. Right now I'm going to say no thank you. But as you can see here, we also have a bunch of different ways you can get in contact with the library to help with accessing resources or doing research, anything library related. We do ask that you get access to the databases through the library's website. Rather than just Googling ScienceDirect and trying to access it from there, because you probably won't be given access, because ScienceDirect won't know that you should be given access through TAMUCC. But if you start from the library's website and click here, we will authenticate you. You might be asked to log in if you're accessing the database from off campus, but you should be able to get to the page if you go from a library's website. So here we have the homepage of ScienceDirect. Databases all look a little bit different and have a little bit different, little tips and tricks. So we are going to, what we could do is just kind of start typing in our keywords. You can see it's remembered my past searches, or at least some of them. I can also go to advanced search. Most databases, including our own quick search, you can do advanced search or more and get more things to start your research off. So let's say I'm doing research on emotional wellness, and I'm looking at higher education or students in higher ed, college students, something like that. I've put these two terms in quotation marks because I am looking for the term itself. I'm not looking for higher or for education to be in my search results. I'm looking for the term higher education. The same thing with emotional wellness. I'm not looking for emotional. I'm not looking for general wellness. I'm looking for specific emotional wellness. So I've put it in quotation marks to tell the database that I'm looking for this phrase, these two words, to show up next to each other. I've also put "and" in capitals because I am asking the database for something to do with emotional wellness as well as something to do with higher education. So I could complicate this a bit and put a parenthesis and type in "or college or university," and I'm going to put an asterisk. So I've added a few components. So by putting it in parentheses, this is kind of like algebra, gets a little complicated, but I'm saying that everything within the parentheses is one search term. So higher education or college or university. And this asterisk, what I think I'm telling the database is that I'm looking for the root word university. So I could be looking for university or universities, because that kind of changes the end of the word. But I'm looking for the root universit. But I'm still looking for something related to higher education or college and emotional wellness. There are a few other things that I could do to narrow things down from the beginning, but right now I'm not going to do that. I am going to just use my search. It's told me before I've hit search. This is awesome. It's telling me that the wildcards, that asterisk that I tried to use, is not supported from this database. Some databases, like Web of Science, it is an asterisk. Here, I know that's actually a question mark. So I'm going to put that in. That's just another one of those little things that different databases like to do different little things. So I have over 5,000 results. I am not going to sit here and look through all 5,000 results. I'm not even going to get close, not even by a long shot. What I could do is add something. I could say, you know, and coronavirus or something like that, you know, to make it, to kind of narrow down what it is about emotional wellness and higher education or college that I'm looking for. But there are a few other things that we can do here. So I can narrow down by year. So if I'm looking, you know, I just want kind of the last 5 years or so, I could do that. I could say, let's look at 2015 through 2020 and just kind of like what's the newer research on emotional wellness and college students. I could also look at the article type. So I could look at just review articles or review articles and research articles, but what I'm not looking for are encyclopedia or book chapters. So that narrows it down quite a bit. I had 5,000. Now by narrowing down with years and looking at just articles, I'm looking at about 1,800. A review article is something that there's no original research. The authors did not do an experiment. They didn't collect data. The data that they collected was actually other research articles. A research article will have a methods section. It will have a discussion section. It will hopefully either tell you about their data or it'll give you a way to access their data. It's not always the case. But a research article is original primary research, whereas a review is kind of secondary research. Sometimes a professor will ask you for only research articles, or you can have one review article, but additional research articles. So that's what I like about ScienceDirect, is that it tells you right away if an article is a review article or a research article. So again, I have 1,800 results. I'm probably not going to sit here and look through all of them, but let's take a look at what I do have on the first page and see if anything pops out at me. So this first one, it talks about adults with multiple sclerosis, and I'm looking more for college-age students, or I'm looking for adults who are in college. So that one is talking about multiple sclerosis. That's not really what I'm looking for. Here I have a review article, but it's talking about well-being in nursing. Again, not what I'm looking for. Here we have a qualitative study of undergraduate nursing students. Perfect. This is a research article. It is talking about emotional well-being and a particular group, but it's still looking at undergraduate students, which is what I was looking for. So I can click on this title. I could download the PDF right away, but I want to learn a little bit more about what ScienceDirect has to offer. So I have all of the pertinent information. I have the title. I have the publication title, the volume, the year, the page numbers. I have everything I need to cite it. I can see the highlights. I can read the abstract. There's some keywords. Emotional well-being is one of them. That's excellent. That's what I'm looking for. And I can read the entire article. I also have citing articles. So these are articles that cited this article. So that's helpful for me too, especially if I really like this article. I want to look at what other people are doing that cites this particular article. I can also look at my references of this particular article and see if there are other things that relate. So let's see. This one talks about higher education in general, but if I'm looking at, I just want to look at, you know, the United States. This one doesn't really help me, right? So there are ways that you could definitely narrow down your search too. If you decide you only want to look at higher education in the United States, that might be a way to narrow down your search results. Sorry, I'm going pretty fast. I'm just scrolling back up towards the top. Okay, one thing you might have noticed is that I don't see a helpful citation button, a way to quickly cite this cite this article. I can share this, I can email it to myself, my professor, my group mates, if I'm working in a group. I can export using Mendeley or RefWorks. If you have a citation manager, like I have Zotero on my computer, if I click this, it will automatically download the citation into Zotero. If you don't have something like this set up, which I highly recommend you do, and you can always get in contact with the library to learn more about that. But to cite this particular article or something in ScienceDirect, what I like to tell folks is to use the library, the library's website. So if you copy the title and you go back to the library's website, and I'm just going to paste the title right into that quick search button. I know the library has access to it because I got to it through the library, but I want to cite it, and that's what I'm using quick search to help me do. So here we have it. It's that first one. I can go into cite this item, and I can choose a citation format. So here we have the obvious, the APA, the MLA, there's Chicago as well. Oops, I did AMA, that works too. And I can copy and paste this into my Word doc or Google doc or however I'm keeping track of my citations. One caveat is please do look over the citation after you've copied and pasted it. Sometimes a generator like this might italicize something that shouldn't be italicized or leave an important piece of information out, like a year or something like that. So just keep that in mind when you use any citation generator. But the library's citation general is included in that. Let's see if there's anything else I wanted to go over in this little ScienceDirect overview. I don't believe so. Again, if you have questions related to this or anything related to how to use library resources, how to get to library's resources, you can always go to our library homepage. And over here, we have all the ways that you can get in contact with the library.